And a very warm welcome to Angola and Soya as we begin this Congo tour as we follow the River Congo over 30 to 12 legs all the way to Lubumbashi. Our first leg to Brazzaville over 200 miles, so we better get underway. It's 26 degrees, a bit warmer than it was in Norway. Some long legs again on this tour. Yeah, 206 miles. Did load extra fuel on, didn't I? I put it anyway. Yes, I did. Cruise at 7,000 feet. Okay, let's spin ourselves around then. Degrees, ground still like minus whatever. It's crazy. Okay, let's go. Try to get back on that center line, shall we? So I'm using this plane because it's a long leg. In case you're wondering. Fire direct track of 59. There we go. So here we are, this is the estuary of the Congo River. See just how massive it is. It's huge. So yeah, as you know, we are in Angola. Shortly be crossing over into the Democratic Republic of Congo, and then we also have the Republic of Congo as well, which is where we'll be landing. Brazzaville and Kinshasa opposing each other. FCBB. Brazzaville. Info. 23 and 5. Let's be up. FCBB, sort of the weather we can expect on arrival. So 33 degrees. Whew. That's warm. I'm at 23. Right, so well, we'll try it to cross the river. Might as well come on runway 5 then, I guess. See if we can get some nice shots as we continue up. Congo Delta. So flight time estimated. And 15 minutes, cool. That's alright, it's not too bad then. Light wind's pretty pleasant. Well, there is some cloud about there. As we leave the coast, far, far behind us. After a cruising altitude of 7,000 feet. Deepest river in the world, apparently, the Congo. Feet places. It's crazy. Thank you. when we're flying to Kinshasa, Brazzaville, the nearest two capital cities in the world, if you don't count the Vatican and Rome. Fascinating. Just reading about the Congo River. Not the best thing down there, unfortunately. Cloud. Encounter now, they will be above that for the most part. The Congo originally ended where we're going now. Then it burst through and carried on down to the coast. So we're in the Democratic Republic of Congo now. We left Angola behind us. We won't return on this tour. Angola, in fact, is the other side of the river there. should have figured that the big maps wouldn't be best in this area. It's not horrendous, but it could be. You can see where they've obviously just put default texturing in to cover over bad data areas. A few mountains now, of hills rather. Congo winds away from us, but we'll meet it up again soon. Pretty pleasant, pleasant day at the moment. We have 158 nautical miles to go. It's just under an hour. Awesome. 23 nautical miles to go. So we've got the PC6 Porter now, and I didn't want to use it for this tour, but it's quite a slow plane. So if we get any shorter legs, I'll use it. For these longer legs, I'm going to be... I know I normally alternate between this and the Islander, but longer legs, I'm going to use this. It's for time management. Fish you get in the Congo. I'm fish tetras. It's that thing. My big teeth. Yeah, you wouldn't want to muck about with that fish, that's for sure. No, look at this. That's disappointing. That is disappointing. Patch of, yeah, they need an Africa update for... big maps, don't they? Nice. quite a bit of cloud bubbling up places. You see big swathes of the river. You think here would be a bit of a bottleneck, just come over there, but there we go. Be able to flip the fuel switch soon. Adding on that fuel burn. See the other tank with plenty. Let's see what a long leg this is. I'm not even flying anywhere now. I did put the flaps up, right? So it's fine that I didn't. I lean the mixture a bit. Make it go a bit faster. There we go, look at that. Get a bit more speed out of it. That's better. A bit more, let's see what happens. Perfect. Getting more speed. Okay, let's flip the fuel switch as well. Squeeze even more speed out of it. There we go. A fair bit of cloud through it. land in. Is that 30 minutes? Yeah, pretty much. If it thought round the river, it'd be really good. It's unfortunately not. some of this Bing imagery is a bit disappointing, isn't it? I can see the whiteness over there where the cloud is still on the scenery. Shame. The big swathes over there, you can see obviously. Oh well. I mean, that's always going to be a case, really, wasn't it? It shows Africa really needs, and other parts of the country as well really do need a. Look at that big white band over there. Some attention, the world update attention, better. Satellite data, if they can get it. I'm sure it'll come. I think the next world update's Italy and Malta, isn't it? It should be good. Thereafter, it'd be nice if they could do some other places. Oh, we're getting closer. 69 nautical miles out. If your situation is fine, it's not going to be a problem.
Yeah, excuse me.
Yeah, this is all I'm gonna fly. Ah, that's a pretty dramatic and then the other side there. We get some outside views, shall we? Very light winds. Far, far from the coast now. They've literally crossed to the Republic of Congo. So literally the border is the Congo. Interesting. All the way up, the most part is the way. Did you realize how big Africa is? It's massive. Ready to decide on the next tour, because this one's only got 12 legs. Don't know. Consult the Fly UK Flying Club tour where we head. We've done a bit of Europe recently now in Africa. We should go back to the Americas, I think. Do something over there. Caribbean tour, maybe. That sounds quite appealing. Yeah, I might do the Caribbean tour. Have to see. Track 58. Need to head back that way. About 15 minutes from landing now. As lengthy old flight, hasn't it? One of the longest legs of this tour. There are a few other longish ones. I need to find a logo for this tour as well, because I can't obviously use a country flag on a map like I normally do, because it spans several countries. I have to see what I can find. I would say several countries spans three, mostly two, mostly one actually. Still see the satellite imagery and needs cleaning up. Certainly not snow down there, that's for sure. It's the trouble with areas like this. They do need improved data. Clouds look great though, don't they? Nice sort of some high level cloud there. That's quite a low level cloud here. Looks nice, I like it. So we're landing runway 5. So we're good with our track position. It's about 45 or 50 degrees, so it's just a fly straight in. So we've got total headwind. In fact, yeah, we're flying straight in because we're at track 51. So let's obviously need to off to our left. Sorry, I'm talking about off to our right in the distance there. See, I imagined Congo to be a lot more mountainous. I'm sure it is in places, but it's reasonably flat here, isn't it? Temperature, incidentally, at this altitude is still a very warm 16 degrees, and we are at 7,000 feet. Though we're fast coming up on Brazzaville. Where's the airport in relation? Is it in the middle of the city by any chance? Sasha, Brazzaville, testing. So it's nice to be back in Africa actually, after all that snow, my last two tours. Must be somewhere a lot warmer. Destinations we'll get from this tour. Every tour I've done usually has a couple of airports you're like, wow. Excuse me. Now we're coming in at runway 5, which, as you can see, yeah, it's just up there. Nice, 1,000 feet up. The airport is, so yeah, we'll be landing very soon. Okay, 20 nautical miles out, bearing 60, so a little bit too high, we need to come the other way now, push that back round, see the cities ahead of me there actually. So we're thinking about descending momentarily. Send down to 4,000 feet. Switch it on. So we'll vacate general aviation apron is right at the end actually. Literary apron's on the left. So we'll vacate right, ideally, if we're doing this properly. Let's re-descend down to our destination, first stop. Up sprawling city. Be some more isolated destinations on this route, I would imagine. But yeah, here we go. Wow, what a place! Quite spectacular, isn't it? So, here we go. Two closest capital cities in the world, if you don't include the Vatican. So, on the left here we have Brazzaville. On the right, we have on the left, of the Republic of Congo, we have Brazzaville. On the right, we have Kinshasa, of the Democratic Republic of Congo. And we want to increase our rate of descent now. That's about That's 500. That's 3,000, 2,000 feet above. What is it? Yeah, cool. Slow it down. Interesting stuff. In fact, I can see the airport ahead of me there. Yeah, the runway in sight. Yeah, this is jungle, and then just going for the big sprawling massive city all of a sudden. Epic. This looks like there's two runways over here, so I'm going to try and work out. Yeah, there is. Well, that makes life interesting. So we want the left one for sure. The other one is no longer with us. This city is not what I expected. I mean, look, it's sort of really, well, green. They're coming in quite high as well. Maybe we can kick the autopilot off and handle it from here, right? That's getting a bit more built up. There we go. Still remarkably green though, isn't it? City. As we prepare to land in Brazzaville. Try and focus, not be distracted by the scenery. I should get some regional architectural appearance to these British buildings, because I imagine the houses don't look this all this grey in real life. It's an interesting city, that's for sure. Used to not landing on a white coloured runway, actually, covered in snow. So, bear with me on this one. can see the X's on the other runway, right? Oh, wait, there's an X on this runway as well. So which one am I supposed to land on, huh? So that you can't land on either one. Well, gee, thanks. Both runways are closed. Oh, no! To get landing in Sasha instead. Right, we're a bit high over the threshold. It doesn't really matter because... plenty of run. Plus we want to exit down the bottom of it anyway. There we go, we are down in Brazzaville, folks. And when this chart does not support moving maps, they're great. So that's what we'll vacate on the next one. Hype is the next one. Stupid X's across the runway, seriously. Anyway, welcome to Brazzaville. We'll vacate to the right here. Follow him, shall we? No, I'm not sure really. Oh, here we go. Look, I found the general apron. Thanks to this random airport vehicle. Well, that was a flight and a half, wasn't it? Is he just going to drive his? Yes, he is. He's just written off someone's aircraft. The man's a lunatic. Needs to be stopped. Call airport security. Let's go and park over it next to the other SR-22, shall we? Hey, look at you, looking good. Looking exactly like me. There we go, right. Let's stop there and have a look at the replay, shall we? We really floated that landing, I know, but I wanted to because of where we had to vacate, so that was kind of deliberate. Okay. Stop. Playback. Get some nice views as we come in over the city. Includes the first leg of the tour. Well, the population of Brazzaville is. We come down. Yeah, we flared a little bit too soon. Should have taken the power off first and then we just gently touch down in the end. There we go, it's a very good landing. That mega float. And there we go. That finishes our first leg here in the Congo Tour. We'll see you on the next leg. Farewell for now.